Rupee registered a low and high of 73.9050 and 73.07 before ending the week a lot firmer at 73.14. Anticipation of foreign fund inflows from overseas investors into Indian companies may prompt traders to place bets in favor of the Indian currency. However, we strongly feel that the central bank should disallow any rise in the rupee exchange rate beyond the 72.5070 level. On the other side, the growing risks to global economic recovery due to spike in COVID-19 cases has lifted the greenback to its highest level in nearly 2 months, which guided a slightly weaker trend in the rupee on the opening day of the past week. In the last 30 minutes of trade on Friday, the rupee significantly gained to register a high of 73.07, indicating that further sharp gains in the rupee can be seen in the coming week if the RBI abstains from intervention in the market. Resurgence and widespread in coronavirus cases has created fears in the mind of the investors. We are of the opinion the performance of the local stocks and dollars gains against the other currencies shall be the guiding factor to determine the rupee's trading range in October 2020. In the event of any undue volatility in the rupee exchange rate in the second half of October, the central bank shall intervene to limit the rupee's losses. The ratio of forex reserves to the external debt of the country was 87% at end March 2020, and currently the percentage of foreign exchange reserves has increased to over 90% of the aggregate external debt as a result of huge capital inflows into the market in the June to August 2020 period. The forex reserves of the country stood at $542 billion as of September 25, 2020, and the central bank has added close to $1 billion to the forex reserves on a net basis in September. The huge forex reserves position provides comfort to the market that in the event of any huge forex outflows from the market at any point of time in the future, the central bank has the ammunition to actively intervene in the market to support the rupee from any free fall. The gains in the BSE Sensex and Nifty at the beginning of September 2020, following strong global queues, points out to the start of a new trading range in the rupee, possibly between 72.50 to 73.60 with a neutral bias. In the current circumstances, it would be a good strategy for the importers to hedge their short-term payables at or near the lower end of the above referred range. It is quite possible to see a rebound in the rupee exchange rate to 73.80 or so sometime in the coming weeks, which should be the targeted exchange rate for the exporters to hedge their month-wise receivables at least up to the next 4 month maturities. At this point of time, we are of the view that RBI would disallow any sharp appreciation in the rupee exchange rate beyond the 72.50 mark at a time when the external demand is picking up and maintaining a competitive exchange rate is imperative for the exporters to gain advantage in pricing of their products in the overseas markets. Due to significant fall in North in quarter one of the current financial year has recorded a surplus of $19.8 billion. Due to COVID situation in the globe, India's current account surplus cannot be considered as a favorable factor for the Indian economy. The budgeted market borrowing of the government has significantly increased in the current financial year. The ballooning fiscal deficit and increased government borrowing in the October to March 2021 period remains a cause of worry. Due to sharp rise in the rupee exchange rate, the strong receiving interest in the swap market guided the forward dollar premium in near-term maturity to gradually decline. The 1 month, 2 month, and 3 month forward dollar premium ended the week a tad lower at 3.70%, 3.78%, and 3.83% per annum respectively. The forward market differential between the 3 month and 12 month maturities have widened to 0.40% per annum, and for forwards beyond the 6 month tenure are trading much higher.